As the decade comes to a close, which is crazy, by the way, one NBA writer compiled a list of the league's best shooters from the past 10 years. The rankings took into account shot difficulty, total scoring, as well as efficiency and other analytic categories. Coming in at number one was Steph Curry, which seems easy. Kevin Durant came in at number two due to his ability to score at any range efficiently. And rounding out the top three was good old LeBron, thanks to his dominance around the rim.
Good old
and LeBron. In the paint. Yeah, good old LeBron. Thought I'd add that in there.
Shocking.
O-L-E.
Yeah.
Not OLD.
Oh, yeah.
Old bra.
It wasn't old.
That what I say?
No, I thought
it's supposed to be just a fun way to look
old.
At
old.
No,
I didn't
said,
mean it that way, but old. I see where you're confusing it. Shannon, do you agree with the rankings?
Got it right. Got it right. I got no problem. Skip. Look, I don't think anyone has any problem with the top two guys. We know Steph Curry is the greatest range shooter in the history of the NBA.
He is.
Once he steps across half court, he's within range. KD. We've never seen anything like him.
Nope.
A guy that's 7 foot tall can put the ball on the floor. Dirk can shoot the ball like KD, mm-hmm. but he couldn't put it on the floor. He nope. couldn't move like KD.
Agreed.
So we've never seen anything like that. Mm-hmm. I think where the pushback is going to start to come, especially from you, is my old guy, LeBron James, saying, nah. You see, Skip Bayless, like you tell me all the time, I like, well, Tom Brady can't run. Mm-hmm. Well, he doesn't need to when he can just sit right there and get the same result throwing the ball. Mm-hmm. See, LeBron James doesn't have to shoot a high percentage from the three. We can just get to the lane. Because guess what, Skip? A layup is a shot. I guess you didn't know this, but the dunk is a shot also.
Yeah. I mean, nobody considers it shooting.
Yeah, shooting.
Shooting.
Let me ask you a question.
So I'm a great shooter because I can dunk.
Hey, Skip, if you make an 18-foot shot and I make a layup, who gets more points?
Nobody.
We get the same. Yeah. So LeBron James said, why should I be out here when I can get to the rack at point in time I want?
Yeah.
And that's what he does. But he shoots, still can shoot. Guess what? Did you know that, Jen? I know you didn't know this. He shot a higher percentage from the three than Kobe and Jordan. And the three-point line been in existence since 1979. Chris Paul was the first one. That ain't none of my business, though, Skip Bayless.
I'm glad you brought that
up. I'm glad I brought it up, too. So, since this decade is coming to a close, LeBron James.
As is his career.
In probably 3-4 years. Mm. Yeah, I'll be really getting 20 all-time leading score, 10,000 points, 10,000 rebounds, and probably another one or two championships. And we close this out on an illustrious career. An illustrious.
It is illustrious. I'll give you that. You know, 3-6 in the finals.
What? About to be 5-6. About to be 5-6.
Could we get a little due on that? I think we have some due.
We got it this year. Go get a title this year.
Okay. So when I first saw this list last night, I thought, top five, what is wrong with this picture? Steph Curry, one of the greatest three-point shooters ever, if not the greatest, right?
Yes.
Klay is right there with him. And on some nights, I think Klay's even better than Steph from three.
He definitely can heat up quicker
back
than
and
Steph.
Forth. James Harden simply revolutionized offensive basketball. He can score from anywhere, any way, shape, or form.
Okay.
And you mentioned KD. He's an unstoppable force from three, from mid-range, or getting to the rack.
Yes.
So what do they all have in common? They're all extraordinary free throw shooters also, because career Steph is 91%. Career KD's 88. Career Klay is 85. And career James is 86. And then we have this guy in the middle at number three, and he's career 34% from three and 74% from the free throw line, which is way below average. It's not a pretty sight. And I'm thinking, he's a shooter? He's on the greatest shooters list? Well, as the article points out, a shot can be made from point-blank range.
Yes.
And so the conclusion in the piece is, while interior shooting is an entirely different skill from jump shooting, James is the Steph Curry of close-range buckets. Bingo! Agreed. What have I said since the cold pizza days on national TV? LeBron James is simply the greatest driver of the basketball we have ever seen, and it ain't close.
Yeah.
He is a what are we going to give him, 260 or two? Is he
250? We draw a little weight. We won't play a little lighter this year.
Okay, let's say he's 250, but in his day, he was 270, 280. Let's do 280. He was a 265-pound freight train to the basket. And even worse for the defenders, he's ambidextrous, because sometimes I think he's even better with his left than his
right. Well, the only thing that he does is shoot a basketball with his right hand. He's left-handed.
Because there are times when I'm looking at him and I think, is he left-handed? Because he looks left-handed at the basket.
And he told the story of why he started shooting the basketball. Yeah. He said all the great players shot right-handed.
Okay.
So he wanted to shoot right-handed.
So he's a combination of Harden and Westbrook when he drives, because you can't keep him from the right side or the left side. He's going to score the basketball on you. But what did that lead to early in his career? And I pounced on this, and I dug in on this in his, like, his second year going into his third year. He was such a poor free throw shooter that he started running from the free throw line late in games because he was an unstoppable force. He could get to the rim anytime he wanted, but there's also a way in basketball, there's this rule that you can actually foul people.
Right.
So if you want to just wrap him up and tackle him, you could do that late in the game and make him go stand there by himself with no time on the clock, and he's got to make one free throw to tie, one out of two to tie, send it to overtime. He's not great in that situation. So it became his Achilles heel of his game. Greatest driver of the basketball is not a great shooter. I'll give him average shooter, but as a free throw shooter, he's below average. He just can't seem to ever find the right grip and stance. He changes his routine by the night to where it gets painful to watch. And then the stat I'm going to hit you with one last time. Since his rookie year, when it comes to potential game tying or go-ahead free throws in what's called the closing time, the last 5 seconds of fourth quarter overtime, he is the worst percentage free throw shooter in all of basketball over this decade, so his time in the league. Yeah, but that's since his rookie year.
And I'm going to be able to push back on you with this one.
Okay, well, wait a second. He's 10 of 18. That's 56%. So
that's not good.
Put him on the line. He's probably going to gag it.
Since his rookie year, when it comes to last-second shots, who's made the most? 12 or 23?
Yep. It's taking a lot of them.
No. 12 or 23. Mm. That's better than Michael. That's better than Kobe, who are thought as cold. They're assassins, Jenny. Mm. Jenny, did you know Kobe Bryant and Michael Jordan are cold-blooded assassins? And that's why I can't put LeBron there, because he's not an assassin.
Is that what it is?
No clutch gene.
All I know is he got more game-winning shots. Okay. More game-winning shots.
Yeah. If he can get point blank, if he can get to the basket, he can make that basket.
Did you see that three hit against New Orleans last year?
Yeah.
You remember that one?
No, I don't even remember.
When AD was sitting on the side last night, that's what I want to play with.
Oh, really?
That was when AD came to the conclusion. At that very moment, when LeBron hit that three, when it just dropped out of the heavens.
Really?
Shot it so high up in there.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I want to play with. I want to play with him.
Yeah. I gave you the two the year before against Jimmy Butler and then against Indiana. Remember those two?
Oh, we did it. Yeah. Oh, we got Toronto, too. We got the baby dinosaurs.
Yeah.
You remember when he had that one?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, yeah, that was the one where he shot it. Oh, yeah, this is the one where he's running, and
he shot off the glass.
He accidentally shot it off.
Cause when you got that kind of money, the bank always open. Yeah, if you got that kind of money,
always open.
Yeah, get any kind of money you want to. We'll have to keep it.
Remember, Ty Lue let him inbound the ball and just go against Ananobi. Remember, he just dribbled up the court full speed.
But guess what? We had given it to Ananobi. We had given it to Siakam. We had given it to Ibaka. We had given it to everybody. Because if you don't remember, Skip, we averaged 34-99 throughout the entirety of the playoffs.
You remember what happened against Indiana when he goaltended on one end and the Pacers all saying, what is going on? He goes the other end and makes the game-winning shot while everybody's shell-shot.
What about the other end when he was stepped out of bounds?
You remember
that with Indiana? Yeah. Indiana was out of bounds. The referee said he was out of bounds. It should have been called. And it should have been,
that was with 5 minutes left.
No, it was not. No. Yeah. That was the play before LeBron went out there and pinned the shot to the,
goaltend.
Skip.
Obvious goaltend. You got to call that.
Two of the greatest blocks. What was the greatest block in NBA history?
Bicycle built for two.
There was no bicycle built for two.
Yeah, it was.
Rained out the rafter. Yeah.
So is he?
Iggy said he still don't know where it came from.
Can LeBron shoot?
Yes.
You know what we all think of as shooting? No.
Oh, hold on.
No.
If you don't mind me asking, still, what was he doing in Game One of the NBA Finals in 2017?
I'm glad you brought that up.
Really? But he can't shoot. A guy that can't shoot had 51, and most of them was jumpers and threes. Turnaround at that.
He had scored, what was it, with
48. He had 48 regular.
48 with 10 seconds left in the game, and he gets a defensive switch of little tiny Steph Curry on him.
Yeah, 49.
And when you don't have the clutch gene, you don't have the guts to rise up and just shoot a 15-foot jump shot over 6 foot. What is he? They call him three. I don't think
he's 6 feet. Why did Michael Jordan shoot over? Why did he pass it to Steve Kerr? Why did he shoot over?
Okay, but that was a called play. This was a last-second play. Shannon said, he made the right play. Chris Broussard, he made the right play.
That's what they do.
George Hill?
Live
you want
with
George
the
Hill to shoot those free throws?
Live with the results, Skip Bayless. You make
shoot
the,
it. Shoot it. If you're the king, shoot the shot.
Skip.
That could have made royalty
it's kinda
out
like,
of him.
It's kind of like a quarterback throws the pass and the guy drops it. Why did he throw it to him? That was the but retook him.
All those ones that he made were those where you have the safety net where it's a tie game, and if you miss, you just go to overtime. Right. That shot at Golden State in game one was do or die because you're down one and you're going to make it or you're going to probably miss it and the game is going to be over. And then what did he do? He just folded up and pouted through the overtime. Because, you know, the rest
kinda of like the kind of like the Spurs did in game six. Remember the overtime? How they just pouted?
They didn't pout.
Yeah, they did.
No, they didn't.
What happened?
Ray Allen shot him right in the heart.
No. They were still living. Yeah. And then what happened in game seven?
They were just psychologically destroyed.
Not a Popovich team with Tim Duncan.
No, not
Tim Duncan and Manu Ginobili.
They fought, but they were just like shells of themselves.
Of course we did, because that's what we do to you.
They had them. They're up five with 18 seconds left
for
the championship. You're 18 seconds for the championship. You got a five-point lead. Who couldn't hold a five-point lead?
Guess what? You burnt the money. You know when you gamble, you're going to touch the money, Jenny.
Yeah, but you know
if you burn the money.
You knew who gagged. Number two stepped right up to the line.
Oh, whoa. What was Manu?
Number two.
What was Manu?
Don't do that.
He gagged before.
We could spend so much longer on this. But we don't need any more of that, although you might be gagging about this next thing. Why is Aaron Rodgers backing Tom Brady?
That's a good question.
Shannon.